Mixing playback along with live musicians is always an interesting endeavor because you're blending digital with analog and you're blending something that's very set with something that's very fluid. Luckily, with all of the gear that we've been privileged to use on this run, it's been really easy and smooth to blend the two pretty seamlessly into one front of house mix that we think sounds pretty badass. Everything is compact and flyable. We went from a fly date tour in Australia to a fly date tour in Europe to a bus tour with fly dates in the US. Every single room has been sold out and it's been all varying sizes. So having something as flexible as a compact rig like this has been absolutely essential to the project. The playback system is in a 4-space rack right now. We're actually going to move down to a 2-space rack because the iConnectivity devices are so efficient, we don't need those extra spaces for DI racks anymore. We're pretty excited about that. A typical tour rig for rooms the size that we're doing with the amount of gear that we have would probably be 2 box trucks at least. We definitely wouldn't be able to fit it into a trailer. Right now we have just a bus and trailer traveling with us, and we're able to fit our entire lighting package and audio package, all of our backline, into one trailer. There's no way we would have been able to do that with analog gear, even previous versions of digital gear, so having the compact system again, it's made life so much easier. The biggest thing about mixing live musicians along with playback is making sure that your playback rig is 100% solid, so that the musicians know it's going to start on time, it's not going to fail. All they have to do is stick to that click, and they know the playback is going to play right along with them. So you can't talk to a playback rig the way you can communicate with a live musician on stage, so it's super important that that gear doesn't fail. That's been the biggest challenge. Yeah, iConnectivity's not failed. We did with the previous rig have a couple of dropouts that were not great for anybody on stage, so we're really, really happy with this new piece.